pinning my microphone back on. I've just made a few videos because I haven't been steady on YouTube, and I apologize about that. But I was finished and I'm losing my voice even, but then I thought, oh, guys, I got to talk to you about this next thing because it's so important, because so many of us live in active shame. So many of us live in passive blame, blaming ourselves, blaming other people. And I'm such a great example of this. Like, I shame myself without even knowing, based on inner narratives, based on patterns. I blame myself based on all sorts of different things that have come before this moment. And it is my work to get into all that stuff and undo it and learn how to let myself off the hook. And here's one thing that has helped me to let myself off the hook. And I want to turn this on alcohol. Alcohol. I have shame around alcohol. Because I'm an alcoholic? No. Because my dad was a terrible alcoholic. Because my mom was a terrible alcoholic. And in their alcoholism, they visited such misery on me, on my brother, and on our collective lives. I know better than to ever abuse alcohol. And so, because a sister likes a glass of wine every now and again, it is always met with this snowball of shame. Like, why do you need that glass? Do you need it? What's beneath that glass of wine? And I'm always inspecting my motives. And, you know, sometimes those of us doing the work can get a little OCD about the work. We can get a little carried away thinking everything is work, and it's not. Some things just are. But because I have stuff, residual tentacles around booze and alcohol, like, I'm always having this conversation with myself. But recently, I was listening to somebody and they were talking about pleasure rituals. And I mentioned, this is Christiane Northrup, who I love. She's an author. She's a doctor. She's 100% pure love. Dig her. Goddess. She was saying the reason people live to 100 years old is because they don't deny themselves pleasures. Whether that's a ciggy, which I don't believe in cigarettes, whether it's a cigar, they don't deny themselves one cigar once a day. They don't deny themselves a bar of chocolate every night. They don't deny themselves a cookie or whatever it is that they do. They don't feel guilty around that. They associate, they totally flip it on its head, create a new paradigm where that thing that they might have shamed themselves for, you know, smoking a cigarette, we could really get into shame around that, and I know a lot of you do, flipping it and looking it as your personal pleasure ritual. Look, if smoking is obstructive to you spiritually, you better believe God's going to let you know. You're going to be asked to wean that out of your life, and that's just how it goes. But if something is actually benefiting you, vibrationally speaking, benefiting your frequency because it's making you happy to do whatever it is, then that's a good thing. And so me, you know, with one glass of wine, having all of these scripts go off, I have begun, I'm not a pro, because I still got stuff, but I have begun to flip the script on that and say, well, it's just a glass of wine, and I like it, and I get to have it, and maybe a bit of cheese, or maybe a little bit of chocolate right before bed, and it makes me feel all warm in my tummy, and I love it. Pleasure. Why can't that be a ritual? I turn tea and coffee in the morning into this elaborate ritual, and I dig it. I gotta tell you, I recommend it. Waking up, putting the water on, getting the coffee beans, and I've selected them. They're organic, and they smell so good. I smell them. I put them in the grinder. I grind them up fine today, a little coarser today. I get out my cream. I get out my organic sugar or my honey. Like, I get out my Kerrygold butter because I do it bulletproof. And it's this whole thing. And I swear to God, it takes me like 40 minutes for me and my husband. And then my husband and I sit outside with our cups of coffee and we talk. What's this day going to be like? What are you thinking about for today? What's on your heart right now? What are you interested in? And we start dreaming a little bit. We start chatting a little bit and we have our coffee. It is a pleasure ritual. If we don't have our coffee in the morning, something feels off and we have, in effect, denied ourselves. And we shouldn't. We shouldn't. And so I'm starting to make a different association with that one glass of wine. If it makes me happy in the moment, I'm not going to blame myself. I'm not going to shame myself because that's low vibration. It runs oppositional to what it is that I'm trying to do with my life. And it's okay to have a pleasure ritual around something that society may think is bad, or that your parents did that was bad, or that somebody else told you was bad. Do you get pleasure out of that? If you do, peel away the layers of shame, peel away the layers of blame, and just be happy to do it. Be happy to have your chocolate. Be happy to have your little Cinnabon. Be happy to have your vanilla coffee in the morning all by yourself as you read one chapter of your book. Rock on. You should be doing that. That's what life is about. The more we make space for things like that, the happier we are. The happier we are, the higher our frequency. The higher our frequency, the closer to God and now the attributes of God. The personality traits of God, like miracles and abundance and success, begin to populate our life and fill up our life because we're vibrating at an ascended rate, all because we insist upon these little pleasures. So I let myself off the hook. You know, I still got work around all my stuff, just like you do, but I let myself off the hook, and I strongly suggest that you search your heart and your life and find ways that you can let yourself off the hook too, and that you can just enjoy yourself. Just enjoy yourself.